Hey, you. Wow, it's already been a week again. I don't know exactly what happened. It's Saturday. Well, at least it's Saturday here where I am. I'm still in Australia and I'm still in Airlie Beach. Let me just show you. This is where I go out, have a cup of coffee in the morning and some orange juice. And then I look at this view. Let me just show you. See, down there, you got the marina and beautiful trees, and it's absolutely wonderful. And over here, you got even more views. This whole area is called Whitsunday, and it's great every day of the week, I tell you. It's really a wonderful, wonderful place, and I've been here a bit more than a week now, and I still have a few days here. I'll tell you where I'll be next week, because I won't be here next week. Overall, it's been another week here in Airlie Beach, and it's a small, touristy city with, I just looked it up, population of 1,208. But I guess when the tourists are coming, it gets tripled or quadrupled. It's a place with a lot of tourists, because out there you have all these beautiful islands. You saw the beach, Whitehaven Beach, that I went to last week. There's also Hamilton Island and a few other wonderful, very nice and luxurious places. It's really a hot spot for tourists. And then obviously the Great Barrier Reef is out there as well. I've not been out on the ocean this week. I've had a quiet week. Spent a lot of time going down to the village. It's downhill from here, obviously. And here this Saturday morning, I just went because they've got the traditional Saturday market, where I met an old fart. That's what he called himself. He was making some beautiful handicrafts where he was cutting things out of bones. He said it was a unicorn, but he whispered in my ear it's actually from cow bones. Also did some stuff in wood. A talented old fart. And then there was an even more talented young guy. I don't know exactly how old he was, but my guess is 12, 13 years old, playing the guitar, playing with the loop pedals, singing. I have never seen such a talented young man before on a guitar. It was amazing. Wow. Anyway, welcome. This is the Radio Vagabond. It's both as a podcast and as a video that you can find on the Radio Vagabond on YouTube and the Radio Vagabond on Facebook. So my name is Palabo, and this is the Radio Vagabond. Like I said, it's been a quiet week. I've been spending most of my time here catching up on some more work, but now it's the weekend. I did take a day off where I went for a drive. I went to see a museum, Proserpine Historical Museum, that was recommended to me. It's about half an hour's drive from here, and then I went even further south to a very unique Australian pub that was also recommended to me in something called Kutabul. Here I had one beer because I was still driving, I had a nice chat with a couple of the locals, and very unique place. I won't say that it was worth an hour's drive to get there, but if you are in that area, stop by in Kutabul pub. Special place and very, very old school. I've been in Australia for 47 days now, and I have 21 days left. If you remember, I came just before New Year's Eve. I came on the 26th of December, and I'm leaving on March the 3rd. So that'll give me 3 more weeks here. And I thought, okay, now I've been in Australia more time than I have left, so maybe it's time to do a little bit of reflection, because Australia has been on the top of my bucket list for so long, and I was really expecting a lot. And you've heard me talk about this before, that sometimes when I have super high expectations, I tend to get a little bit disappointed. I wouldn't say that. Australia is great. Cape Town is still my favorite place, but Australia, especially this part of Australia that I've been to, is definitely up there. But I don't think I'll be able to tell you exactly how high it is. Until I've left, really, where I've had some time to look back and think, that was great. There are quite a few similarities between South Africa and Australia. Mostly, the people and the sense of humor and easygoing people. One thing that is different, though, is I was expecting Australians to be a little bit more like the South Africans when it comes to meeting people and randomly going into a conversation. It might be the case in some parts of the country, but when I was in Sydney, I had a conversation with some locals and said, I'm expecting, this is the idea I have, that if you're standing in a line in a supermarket, you would automatically start talking to people. And those people from Sydney said, oh, no, you don't do that. You mind your own business. And that's not the case in South Africa. I had an experience, and it's not only a Cape Town thing. I think it's all over South Africa. I had an experience in Johannesburg when I was on the Nomad Safari. We just started the trip and stopped at a supermarket, and we were two buses with, I think, 35 people total on this Nomad Safari. And I didn't know everybody. I knew a few of them, but I didn't know everybody at the time. And I went into a supermarket where we were supposed to just buy some snacks and some drinks for the trip. And here I saw this young guy with a cart, and he had some stuff on there, and I thought, not even looking at his face, but I just thought, oh, he's one of us, because we were 35 people going into the supermarket at the same time, and I just smiled and said, oh, what did you get? He was obviously not a part of the group, but instead of saying, what do you mean, why are you talking to me, which would happen in many parts of the world, this guy, I guess, 35 years old, he just said, well, I got some cat food, I got some snacks, I got just going through his shopping cart. And then I realized, oh, he's not one of us. And we ended up having a long conversation, and he ended up subscribing to my podcast, because he said, who are you people? And, oh, we're nomads, and I'm traveling full time. Oh, that's exciting. And I don't think that would happen. Maybe it would happen. Maybe some Australians would react to that. Maybe some Danes would react to that and just respond like he did. But it's different in parts of the country, even parts of Denmark. If I did it in Copenhagen, there would be much more of chance of the person saying, why are you speaking to me, or just ignoring me, or saying something nasty. If I was in the rural part of Denmark, where I come from, it might be different. I don't know exactly where I'm going with this, but I was expecting it to be a little bit more open. But then if you are speaking to people, if you're taking the initiative and saying something, they would typically respond. And especially if you're in a bar, you would easily get to speak to people. I made some friends in Cairns and haven't been this much to a bar here. But when I was in Kutapool, like I mentioned, these guys there, we had a nice hour and chatted away. And yeah, so you can start a conversation, and Australians are really easygoing. And speaking of easy, Australia is just a country that's easy to be in. It's very convenient. It's expensive, yeah, but it's very convenient and very easy to be a visitor in. And I would put that on the plus size, if not saying that I don't like challenges once in a while. I've been talking about if it is my favorite place or if it's up there on the favorite list. And that's something that I get a lot. This week I've done two interviews, one with Ben, an Israeli guy, doing a video interview for something he calls Coralini. Oh man, I was so rehearsing to say that. Coralini Kanana. Have no clue what it means, but we had an hour of a conversation, or 45 minutes, and he was in Guatemala at Lake Atitlan, where I stayed with Andres when I was there. He was in San Pedro, or Don Pedro, I think it is, not in San Luca Toliman, where I was with Andres when I was at Lake Atitlan. But he was there, and he did an interview, and I also did an interview for a podcast with Elizabeth, who's a from Switzerland, but lives in Cyprus, and she does a podcast called Most Memorable Journey. And both of these, they ask me, and it happens all the time I'm being interviewed for something, what's your favorite place? You've been to so many places, what's your favorite place? And you know me, I got the answer ready. I say Cape Town, South Africa, and it still is number one. And then if I was to name number two or three, I would have a hard time. I really would. I could give you a top 10, but I wouldn't be able to rank it. And that top 10 list might look different if you ask me a day later. So it is so hard. It also depends on, is it a city? Is it something nature? Is it the country as a whole? What is it that I'm looking for? And I'm looking for a bit of everything. So there are some parts of the world where the nature has been outstanding in so many places. There's also some amazing spots here in Australia. Just showed you a bit of it. And then when it comes to cities, I could name a ton of cities as well where it's just a nice place to be and exciting and lots of things to do. And yeah, I could name a lot there, but it's really something that I don't like to answer because it's so hard. What is your favorite place? Do you have a favorite place? Please make a comment under the video in YouTube or Facebook, or send me an email, a message on theradiovagabond.com/contact. So I'm here in Australia right now. It is super, super hot. I'm here in the summertime and I want to come back when it's the wintertime. That's their high season, especially up here in Airlie Beach and in Queensland. It's really, really hot here. And I take a shower in the morning and then go out here, have a cup of coffee, and then I'm ready to take another shower because it's really hot and it's humid. Next week I'm going to Melbourne, and that's quite a bit south, and it should be a lot cooler down there. So I'm actually, can't believe I'm saying this, I'm actually looking forward to it being a little bit cooler because I like it nice and sunny and warm, but this is really, really hot. So I'm looking forward to getting to Melbourne. And down there, I am also planning to go out of the city. I plan to go up to Purdy Pine. Yeah, you never heard of it, I know. And there's a reason for that, and I will get back to that when I see you next week, and why I'm going to Pretty Pine and also going driving on the Great Ocean Road, and really, really looking forward to it. Before I go, I have just received an amazing news from my good friend Cynthia, like just 5 minutes before I started recording. I've been trying to, Cynthia is my friend from Florida who I did the Saudi Arabia trip with, and we also done some other trips, but if you listen to the Saudi Arabia episodes, you know who I'm talking about. And I've been trying to persuade her to go on the cruise from Sydney to New Zealand, and she's been going back and forth, and 10 minutes ago she sent me a message says that she is coming. So yeah, I got a travel companion, and when we get to New Zealand, we're gonna see a bit of that country as well together before I continue and she goes home. So with that, that's my update for this week. My name is Palabo, and I gotta keep moving. See ya.
Produced by RadioGuru.co.uk.